This is the iPod Shuffle second generation, Apple's budget iPod model, which was originally released in September of 2006. The second gen Shuffle is the most abundant iPod Shuffle on the market, so I thought I'd cover it in extra detail. But most of what I say about it applies to all the other models due to the only minor differences. In this video, we'll be looking into what it's like using these iPods in 2020, many years after they were released, and if they're still worth your money. Firstly, don't forget to hit that like button and check out my channel, and if you like what you see, please consider hitting that subscribe button. Also, go ahead and click that bell notification button to get notified whenever I upload a new video. I'm also on Instagram and Discord, so you can follow me on those using the links in the description. Alright, let's jump right to it. The iPod Shuffle was initially designed to be a budget entry into the iPod lineup. The second generation Shuffle, when released, was the first iPod Shuffle to feature an aluminum body and a clip to attach it to clothes. This was designed based off customer response from the original iPod Shuffle, as Steve Jobs put it. The clip-on design was accepted well and was used mainly for listening to music during workouts and runs. A quick go-around of the device reveals its extremely small size, being only 1.62 inches in width and weighing in at only 15.5 grams. It features a click wheel with button controls, but does not feature touch scrolling unlike other iPod models. Up top, it had a 3.5mm headphone jack. At the bottom lies the shuffle switch, the on-off button, and the indicator light. At the back, we have the belt clip, which is also made of aluminum. It originally cost $79 for the 1GB model at launch and $69 for the 2GB model, which was released in 2008. It was offered in 10 color variants as well. The iPod Shuffle 2nd Gen charges using the headphone jack, as it was too small for the 30-pin connector, which was Apple's connector of choice at the time. It also shipped with a dock, which could be used to charge and sync with iTunes. It was advertised as having a 12-hour battery life, and this was possible because it lacked a display and the only power being drained was from the music playing itself. Controlling the iPod Shuffle is pretty straightforward. Volume up and down, play pause, next track or previous track, and fast forward or fast backwards. The shuffle switch up top toggled the music from playing in order or being shuffled at random, hence the name iPod Shuffle. Now for some feedback on my experience with this iPod in 2020. I completely relied on the iPod Shuffle for music for an entire day, and the experience was simple and pleasant, apart from the fact that I was forced to use wired earbuds as it does not support Bluetooth. I enjoyed the simplicity and ease of use of this iPod. Using it for working out was a breeze, and its negligible weight made it feel like I was using earbuds connected to nothing. So why would anyone want to buy this iPod today? The first reason I can think of is, of course, for working out and exercising. If you wish to not be disturbed by having your phone with you while you're working out, and you want to feel free from having a heavy device to be carried around, this option is definitely for you, as this was the initial intended purpose of the iPod Shuffle. The iPod Shuffle is also pretty inexpensive, so if you're someone that loses stuff easily, it's something you won't feel too bad for losing. It's also possible to listen to podcasts on the iPod Shuffle, and the lack of other features would help you focus more on listening to your podcast better. iPod Shuffles could be bought on eBay from as low as $10 to $30 depending on their condition, and usually come with a decently working battery, as not many people use them for way too long. Battery replacements on these things are pretty hard, and finding parts for them is also pretty hectic. But finding one in decent condition for cheap is pretty easy. The iPod Shuffle was one interesting addition to Apple's iPod lineup, which is now sadly no longer relevant at the time of this video. So finally, that's it for this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Also, don't forget to hit that like button on this video and check out my channel, and if you like what you see, please consider hitting the subscribe button. Thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in my next video.